Design Salvation, episode 88.
This is Design Salvation, your lifeline to better design with Dixie and Annie. Our mission is to share our conversation with you so we can all elevate our work and lifestyle. Welcome to the fold.
Hey y'all, it's Dixie Stark.
And Annie Lundquist.
We are Design Salvation.
And we're really excited to be together because
I know
Dixie's been
trapped
in the South for in 26 below or something crazy.
It was insane.
Yeah, that was your timing really stunk it up, babe.
Oh man. Before I left to go on that trip, which was only supposed to be a 3-day trip, mm-hmm. I literally just needed to go into town, lay eyes on my mama, and come back. Mm-hmm. And before I went on the trip, I looked at the weather report, and I was like, yeah, they always say this is going to happen. Yeah. It never does. And then I also had a call from a girlfriend. I had a call from my dad that were like, you know, we just got a little bit of freezing rain. It's not bad. You'll probably get in okay. When are you supposed to leave? And I, you know, proceed to tell them I was just going to be there for a couple of days. And they're like, yeah, you should be okay to get out because then we're going to get a big storm.
No. It all came together. You had no
out. Yeah. I didn't get out. It was awful.
No, and you were really stuck in your hotel room, so.
Oh, the hotel room that had, first of all, that was my second hotel.
Right.
My second room in the second hotel. I had to change rooms. And then we had the sprinkler pipe burst in the hotel, flooded the entire lobby. The bar and restaurant were not open because of it. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was just like camping. I've done so much sink laundry.
Yeah, camping. Yeah, sink
Girl,
laundry.
Girl, I did the sink laundry because I was supposed to be there for 3 days, and I ended up being there 9.
Oh, was it 9?
No way. 9
God, that's way
days
too long.
In a hotel.
With your husband trying to work.
Yeah, we're both trying to work, and he's running down the hall to try to go to the conference room, and mm-hmm. I'm trying to do, you know, a little bit of this. I didn't have any resources. I only had my phone with me. I'm looking at my phone, trying to answer emails and phone calls and try to rearrange my week in which I had an installation. And had to push that off. And I mean, it was, you know, when you have an installation, you have multiple vendors and multiple people you're coordinating with. So everybody from, you know, window coverings to rugs to the closet people were supposed to install. Then I had mattresses coming. I had furniture coming. I had furniture coming from another source, furniture coming. I had to like call 12 people.
To cancel. Yeah, that's a lot.
It was such a nuisance. So anyways.
Well, you did go to the bar across the street.
That was important. Yeah, you know, this is funny. I had to walk. Because you couldn't drive because mm-hmm. there was so much snow and ice and it was bitter, bitter cold. And there were limited places open, but there was one place called Feet and Folly. And apparently it's quite, you know, popular
this
with college
Fayetteville,
kids.
Arkansas,
yeah, it's in Fayetteville,
by the way. I don't think we said that.
I don't think I said it was in Fayetteville. It was in, oh, yeah, super cute. It's where I went to college. So anyways, I found a drink there, though. I tried to make it here. I kind of failed, but I kind of did good. Kind of failed.
Well, it was too strong for me to even.
Yeah, you couldn't even.
I took a whiff of it and
you're
said
like,
nothing.
No, thank
but
you.
What's it called?
It's called the Arkansan.
The Arkansan. I always say I want to say the Arkansasian.
Well, you know what? I do have a little issue with that because people will say, "Is it Arkansas?" And I'm like, "No, it's mm-hmm. Arkansas." So when they say Arkansan, it kind of irritates mm-hmm. me a little bit. But okay.
But this is a powerful.
A powerful drink.
Brew.
It basically you get one of those big ice cubes, bitch. That was one problem. We didn't have those, which mm-hmm. had little crushed ice. And you pour your Irish whiskey, equal parts we discovered of Irish whiskey and an apricot liqueur. And then you top that off with some fresh ginger and some black walnut bitters. I
mean, it really does sound good, but we just need to work on it a little bit. I think Deke would love it.
I think, you know what, men. Yeah. It is a favorite. Like if you were going to have like a dinner party and you had, you know, couples, the guys would probably dig this. Mm-hmm. I think they'd be into it. It feels like something that you could drink year round. I will say that because it's a little bit sweeter. Like if you, you know, an old fashioned is more orange based. This had the apricot, which was a little twist.
That's a nice little twist.
But my question is I couldn't figure out what this had to do with Arkansas. I was like, apricots, we don't have them. Black walnut, I don't think we're mostly oak, you know, down. I don't know about that.
Ginger.
Fresh ginger. That doesn't,
sound
right either. And then it was supposed to be Irish whiskey. I'm like, what happened to bourbon? At least Kentucky's our neighbor. So I was a little bit befuddled by that, but it was tasty.
Good. Yeah.
And it helped me.
I'm glad.
It helped me. It helped me get through that one afternoon. Yeah. And then I had about six other afternoons to get through. But anyways, there you go. All good.
It's an ordeal when you travel and then you get home and it hasn't really been a break. I think that's
it wasn't a break.
Common struggle we've all been through.
It was not a break. It basically, while I was there, I was stressed for the most part. Yeah, I had some good downtime because there's a time change and that helped me a little bit. I get up a little bit earlier and I had a couple hours before my phone started going off and that was kind of nice. But for the most part, I was pretty stressed while I was there.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Yeah. So anyways, everybody was stressed in Texas. My Lord, did you hear all that?
Well, yes, because Lulu's there.
Although, is she okay?
Well, she was very fortunate. So her house, for some reason... She has two roommates. It's new, but I don't know why. They somehow didn't lose power and everybody else did. So they had hot water and power. So everyone came. They had like 12 girls come for a sleepover. She said it was one of the most memorable, wonderful.
Wow.
And they played like those murder games and they played Survivor. You know, those little mystery.
Oh, mystery. Mystery. Like murder games.
No.
Murder mystery. Okay.
Murder mystery.
And fun.
They all cooked and they cooked big breakfasts. And
oh, that just sounds
shared
fun.
They had a blast.
Oh, good. I'm glad for the gals that didn't have power and water, you know, because my parents they had their pipes burst. And I mean, it's just been one thing after another. Arkansas and Texas and Louisiana, they're not set up for this cold weather.
Well, this is wicked.
Well, we
cold.
Had snow here. I missed it.
We had it a lot. I was sorry you missed it. It was gorgeous.
I love it when you do get to have a snow day in the conveniences of your warm house and, you know, you're working water. But it was a lot warmer here. That was the difference.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it was lovely.
Anyways. So what do you know?
Well, so I'm just going to start out with a little confession.
Right off the bat?
Yeah, right off the bat.
We just haven't seen each other. Okay, so you just... Okay, Salvationites, we have a confession here.
So, you know, we just did this big series on This Is Home by Natalie Walton.
Yes.
And it was about refreshing, you know, right out of the gate on the new year. And living and creating and nurturing.
Sound great.
Yeah.
Sounded great.
I had a really crummy February.
Well, I did too. I hadn't even been here. So that makes two of us.
I was a complete failure at living, creating, and nurturing, or whatever order that goes in. So,
that's okay.
Yeah, like I didn't.
You're forgiven.
Thank you. Huh. I didn't do my fresh flowers. And
But you have them today. They're these lovely pink tulips.
Pink
and white. They're beautiful.
Yeah, today I did. Come through. Deke went to the grocery and I said, please just bring me tulips. And I don't know why I haven't been saying that.
This whole time?
Yeah. And we have been lighting some candles, but not like I usually do. I was in the February funk.
It happens.
It does. And I just want y'all to know that as much as we preach all this good stuff, we succumb to these.
Oh, yeah.
These ruts and whatever it is. But I'm not super proud. So that's my confession.
That you're not super proud about your February.
No, my February.
Well, you know what? March is here.
Well, this
March
is true.
Here.
It's so be gone,
yeah. Be done with February. March is here.
Yeah. And I think that I'm excited because we are going actually to Florida on Sunday.
Yeah.
And so I think that will be a good launch into thinking about sunshine and blue skies.
Heck yeah.
And we will
Florida
be on
sounds
the beach.
Fantastic. Are you kidding?
Mm-hmm.
Well, now we're drinking your drink.
Yeah, so I made a drink.
This is good.
I think I did a little better than Dick's.
Not that we're competing.
Now, don't be naughty. Don't be mean.
But I was thinking more along. Okay, whatever. So I made a gin fizz, which because I was kind of thinking about Mardi Gras.
Oh,
which
yeah. Kinda,
which didn't happen
this year. Oh, I know. It's so sad.
So we made our own little gin fizz. I'd never made one before, but I quite like it. I think it's a great little twist on a mimosa and kind of a good brunch drink.
Yeah, it's got the frothiness that's kind of, it's kind of like a little milkshake, but.
Yeah, like a little creamsicle.
Creamsicle is what it reminded me
and
of.
And I did add fresh squeezed orange juice to mine rather than, you're supposed to add orange blossom water, but that's a little obscure.
Ugh, well, I'd say.
Yeah. So just the fresh lime, the fresh lemon, the fresh orange, and then a little bit of half and half.
I like it.
And an egg white. And then
it's really good.
The frothy comes
and
out.
And some gin, just a little bit. She barely put any gin.
I know, I
didn't. Let's just be for real.
You don't even need to if you wanted to just enjoy it. So, yeah.
That's so great. Well, I like it. It does make me feel a little springier. It has a little spring kind of color and
I agree. Why I got the pink tulips. And I think we should maybe set a spring goal.
You know what? I have a couple of things that are on my list. So maybe my February was bad too.
Okay. Well, let's just move forward to March.
So after I get done with Christmas and what have you, which everybody knows my Christmas is real minimal. It's like put a tree up, put some lights on it, we're done. I just have had the same thing on my table, my big dining table, which is kind of a catch-all. If anybody has been in my house, we use that table for everything.
Well,
we dine at it. I work at that table. Jay and I both have been working at that table. But if there's any wrapping project or if there's any, you know, anything, it's on that table. And that thing's starting to see it's getting some wear.
But yeah, I bet.
I'm wanting something new on the table. And I have a tendency once I get something that works, because I don't have a lot of storage and I don't have a lot of other surfaces to just kind of like, that's what I do. I'm tired of it. So on my spring goal, I'm going to get something new for that dining table.
And do you have something in mind? Is there something you've been
eyeballing. Okay. I've been eyeballing. For a long time, I've had my eye on these vases that are quite lovely. They look to be, you know, mouth blown. I don't know much about them. I need to get more information, but I just have kind of like put the hand out and said, stop, you're not going to do this. But I think that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to do those. And then I found at the antique store, kind of a weird thing. I want to get your opinion.
Okay.
I'm just talking randomly. Is that all right?
I think this whole day is going to be random, sweetie.
Okay, we're just going to talk random. So I found here in the Pacific Northwest, you know how you see those? They're the glass floats, basically.
Yeah,
they're
for
floats
the fishing
for
nets.
The fishing nets.
Yeah, yeah.
I found a huge one. It's huge. Like, I want to say that thing's almost 2 feet in diameter. I may be exaggerating. It's kind of cool, but I need something to anchor it. And I thought, well, if I got those lovely kind of substantial vases, and then maybe I put the float with it, then I don't know, maybe I got a little glass thing going on. I don't know.
That could work.
You've
what color are the floats? Is the float?
Well, the one that I like most of the time, they're bottle green. And the reason I like the one that I found is that it's this pale, pale blue.
Oh, well, yeah,
so I think
I was
it could be
say,
pretty.
I don't
bottle
want,
green.
No,
I don't see that happening in the Stark house. Especially
is that something that you could take out on approval and try it?
Probably so.
Yeah, that might be the thing to do.
I know, because that thing's going to roll around. It's big. It's going to roll around. But I was thinking the combination would be good. But I need to do that. And if we're talking about spring goals, I need to also get new dishes.
That's a fun goal. That's a really fun goal.
It's kind of been daunting for me.
No.
Yeah. I mean, you know, Jay and I both are kind of picky about dishes. And we've had the same dishes since
when
we got married.
Well, you know, I really believe in trial running dishes. So you just order one.
Oh!
Yeah. Takes the pressure off.
Okay, so you order one dish and you say, do I like it?
You use it. You have Jay use it.
Yep. And see.
Yep.
And okay, I'll do that. I have no idea what I really want. And I fear getting a dish that's too big on multiple levels. Like I eat too much.
What are these fears? I don't believe in fears.
Oh my gosh, if I get a dish that's so big, then that means I either have to cook more or eat more or both.
Okay, well, When you're looking for dishes, it does say the dimensions. So I know, think you're safe. Come on, honey. Pull the trigger.
Anyways, okay, so spring goal. Other than the fact that, you know what, we didn't have a landscaper this winter because our landscaper had some family issues and ended up, you know, not being in town and what have you. I got to work on that yard. That lavender. Ooh, that lavender's in bad shape. And so I've got the spring goals to kind of do the things that I was supposed to do in the fall, in the garden.
I'm with you on that. And my other spring goal is to get my little itty bitty flower room done.
Yay!
And so my stone
garden. We tried to do that in November.
I know. It was supposed to be done by Thanksgiving.
Good grief.
We're
going to document that.
I know. He was here templating for the stone sink yesterday. So we're close.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's exciting.
That excites me. And then I think that will propel me to finish that whole back hall. You know, it'll kind of get me.
Catapult you.
Yeah, catapult
That'll
me.
Be good.
So that's a spring goal plus the yard. I think it's time finally. We in the Northwest have a hard time with lawns.
Yeah.
And I love moss.
I know.
But we've gotten way out of balance on our moss lawn thing. So it's time to
get some control on that.
And that's not really very fun, but that needs to happen.
We have so much moss in our driveway this year that we haven't had in the past. So we got to get a handle on our driveway.
My shirt's unbuttoned. You didn't tell me.
Well, I didn't know you were. I'm not looking at your hair. Oh my God. It's hilarious.
I'm like Jenna Lyons.
Oh, you've been watching that.
Okay, y'all, Dixie, I want you to watch it.
Okay, so Yvette, you know, who comes and helps me sometimes, we know, sweet Yvette, she told me I needed to watch it, but now it's on, what's it on? I can't find it.
It's on HBO Max.
I barely have any TV. I never watch TV.
But you could just do a trial, I think, for 7 days, and it's only 8 episodes or something.
I can just totally
do a little binge, mini binge.
Yeah, power through.
And then we'll discuss, I think there's a lot of meat in there to discuss. Some things I like, some things I really didn't like, but her shirt's always unbuttoned. There's a lot of boobage.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, yeah. Bare, no bra.
Seriously?
Yeah, watch. She's cool, but I do have
my goodness,
some
I wasn't expecting that.
And there's a lot of design components, including clothing, fashion styling, plus interior styling, plus some beauty stuff. So,
I loved it when she was with J. Crew. And I like she does good mix and match. I can't always do what she does, but that's okay. I'm not built the way she is, and I'm not in the fashion industry, and so be it. So whatever. But
You're going to have more. You're going to be more critical, I think, as I'm feeling more critical. I always visualize a person like Jenna Lyons who has a big presence. We shouldn't even be talking about this because I want y'all to watch it first. And then
everybody's homework, right?
Yes. That's your fun homework.
Didn't that wrap up last year or something like that?
I think December.
Okay.
Or something. Yeah. So just recently.
All right. So I should be able to. Okay, we're going to do that. And you just button that shirt up. Okay.
I'm going to do another one. Now I'm feeling really vulnerable. Gosh.
I didn't even notice. So there you go. Annie. Oh, that's hilarious. So what are you kind of trending on right now? I mean, I just feel like we just have to have this catch up because I just haven't.
Okay, so I have a house question. I have a little, and I should know the answer to this because if a client asked me, I would.
Oh.
But
you don't know for yourself.
Because of me.
You know what? It is the way it always is. Yeah. Always hard to do your own stuff.
So I'm doing, I need to do a bunch of painting upstairs. Mm. And it's new trim that's finally getting finished carpentry that's getting put up. And so there's a lot of prep.
Okay.
And a lot of caulking and a lot of sanding and then a lot of painting. And I've had someone come in and bid it. And they're not painters that I've worked with before.
Oh, okay.
They did come from someone I trust her.
Yes.
But when we get to the doors and trim, painters always want, they're always like, we'll make this look perfect. It will be absolutely perfect. And I'm like, no,
I don't want that.
I don't want it to look like plastic.
Yeah.
I want you to back brush it. And then they're like, their eyes get really big and that's going to be messy and that's not going to be. And I just want to know what you think about pushing them on that. Or do I need someone whose eyes don't get big?
That's what I'm wondering.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a painter that is amazing. And if you say back brush to him, he's like, okay.
Hmm.
Yeah. All right.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to do it here, here, here. Like he does it, it doesn't flinch. Now, if I'm working on a job or whatever where we're budget sensitive and he'll look at me ever so often, he'll go, you don't want to back brush this, do you? Mm-hmm. I mean, like he'll do the same thing. And I'll be like, no, I, you know, and part of that is not because I don't love the look, because I love the look. It's just time and money.
Yeah.
You know,
you have to make
time and money.
Those choices.
And you have to make those choices. The back brushing, just trying to explain to our audience here, is just a way to enhance kind of the charm of the paint.
Yeah, it just makes it look more like paint rather than some sort of
old,
what, like cooked on finish, like you see in kitchen cabinets, because they have to be more durable, obviously,
yes,
you know.
Because back in the day, the only way you would apply the paint would be with a brush. Mm-hmm. And you would see the brush marks not being perfect. Mm-hmm. And it just looks more authentically painted and not plastic.
And then when you use oil paint, which is when you typically back brush,
yes,
the oil paint takes longer to dry so that a lot of the little lines go away. So you have just a little hint of imperfection.
Just a little hint of it. And so it just looks like it's hand done instead of like, you know, machine fabricated. It's kind of the difference of the two, but it is labor intensive and it does, you know, it requires a lot more effort on the painter's behalf. And so a lot of times they don't want to do that. It's a lot easier for them to just like take it in that bucket and spray it, you know, tape everything off, spray it, give it a couple hours, it's good to go and, you know, move on. So to find somebody that is willing to do that is important. So if they gave you kind of the,
well, and here's the other thing,
they may not be the right fit.
Previously on some other trim work.
And you hated it?
Well, it's just not done well. And so then it looks gloppy.
Oh,
and then going back and mixing that.
You're like, oh, that's a problem.
Oh, it's such a headache. So, okay. I think I will talk to someone else whose eyes don't
get that's kind of used to
it.
One of the things that I've noticed too is that the painters that are used to working on the older, whether it be a historic home or just a more traditional, older home, are usually used to the whole back brush concept because the other things in the house they're matching it to obviously were painted with a brush
at some point. True.
So, I
wanted to just sort of jump off the deep end and say yes to them because we are leaving town and it would be so nice
to come back and have that done.
To have it done because we're going to have, you can't be in the house with that. So, but now
so
I just can't, bring myself to do it.
If they're panicking about that would make me a little bit nervous.
Yeah. So, okay.
Oh, shoot.
I know.
Sorry. You know, paint is one of those things. It's so hard because everybody's expectation about paint is different. Stain is another one. I've got a stain problem going on.
What's that?
Wood is a natural product. Stone is a natural product. Mm-hmm. And so when you go to do hardwood floors and you go to do cabinets and you're working with stain, you have to know that there are certain parts of the wood that are going to take the stain a little bit different. It's not going to be consistent. If that's what you're looking for, it's probably not the way you should go. You should go back to a paint where you've got a consistent swath of color. But I have a couple of jobs right now, two different ones, two different, you know, types of clients, two different all the way around, and they both are seeing the color differently than what I'm actually seeing. Or they're saying, oh, I see a little green in that. Oh, I see a little red in that. And I'm like, no. I mean, you know, like I'm like, are you imagining this or am I the one that's not seeing it right? Like the interpretation is just difficult.
I do think that there's a huge continuum of how people see color, and most designers see color very similarly.
Yeah,
because you have to have some clarity. But I think with the general population that there's this huge spectrum. And I mean, well, I've had colorblind clients, which is hellacious.
Oh my gosh, that's awful. Yeah. I've had, most of them have been men.
Yeah, totally.
Typical of men. And I've also had, I don't know what you call it, you know, where they see things and they start to kind of give them a little bit of a depth perception issue. I don't know. Anyways. But
so do you think with your clients that it's that they're actually seeing green or they're just not seeing what they thought they were going to see?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. And it's funny that you mentioned that because I think that sometimes what happens is a client will say, oh, I'm seeing green or I'm seeing red or whatever, when in fact, they're just not seeing what they want to see.
Yes.
And I'm trying to figure out on both of these jobs, one is for a floor, one is for cabinetry. On both of these jobs, I've got clients that are saying they see something and I'm not seeing it. And I don't know if it's just that they don't like it. And so this is one of the challenges as a designer is trying to get in their head and trying to figure out how to solve the problem so that they're pleased. And then you, in turn, are also pleased with the outcome so that it goes with the other commitments we've already made.
I think often, though, when you give them, let's say they're seeing green, and then you say, okay, let's make a sample where you don't see green.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, they like the green one.
Yeah. That's happened a lot. That has happened. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So there's sort of just a patient process of, first of all, them getting more comfortable seeing
that's
it for
true.
A few weeks, and then you supplying an alternative. And it's still expressing your preference for the quote-unquote
for the original
green one. And then they start to come around.
Yeah.
But it's time. It's complicated and it's time. And
it is. And
it's another thing on your list.
Right. And in both cases, this is going to delay the project.
Yeah.
So where we've got a cabinetry issue, I'm not working off of hardwood floors. Where I have the hardwood flooring issue, the cabinetry's already in. It's just
Well, these
so it's
projects,
a problem.
They're little puzzles and it has to all fit together and it never does because something does get in the works and then your subs can't come because they have another commitment and then you have to wait
two months to get them back.
And
it's just really prolonging that. So I don't know. Kind of gets me to, you know, the work problems right now that I have are delays.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you seeing a lot of delays?
I delayed my own. Here's another confession.
Oh, girl.
I know. This one's kind of embarrassing, but. You know, I'm not working that much right now.
You've scaled back.
Yeah, I've scaled back a lot.
Considerably.
Kind of great. But I went to the design center recently and ordered something for a client and my check bounced.
Love that. That's so
I'm
great.
I'm delaying my own projects now. Cool.
That's so funny. That happens though.
Yeah.
We have a lot of cash flow in and a lot of cash flow out. A lot of cash flow in.
And I had written a ton of checks and I thought I kind of had it in my mind.
Like, oh,
no, I'm good. Whoops.
Whoopsie. That didn't happen. You know, that happens where I might say, for instance, I have, you know, my company debit/credit card and it's like, you know, you start to pay for a $25,000. You know, dollar rug. And then, you know, you go and you buy this and you buy, I mean, it's just the next thing you know, at some point, the bank's going, whoa.
Yeah. Those
I know you do a lot of business, but, you know, $250,000 later, we're just going to question you for a minute. So don't you feel bad?
Thank you. I feel a little bad because Deke keeps talking to Lulu about her credit card situation at school. And meanwhile, I can't manage my little business account.
You're so funny. But that is one of the things that we have to do as business owners is we have to manage, you know, not only the puzzle of design and all that, but we have to manage that dollar end, or we have to get somebody that we're confident in to help us. A lot of even the small businesses will have just maybe one principal designer, one associate or assistant, and then someone that solely just deals with purchasing and
accounts.
And it's a great model if you're wanting to keep your business really tight and small. And as the principal, you're still doing the interiors work. You're still on top of it. You're still the main go-to for that. But you have this little backup that is, you know, supporting you on the back end on those things that, you know,
I don't think
do
I'd
want
to
well.
Be bigger than that. That's like the perfect
Yeah, it's a good size because you still get to be the designer, mm-hmm. you know? Hey, y'all, we're going to pause right here and let y'all listen to the rest of our chit chat next week. So thanks for tuning in and ciao for now. Hey, y'all, don't forget to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. You can also find us at designsalvation.com, where we'll have the past podcasts listed as well as show notes. Hope to see you there.